So I've been traveling in France for the last 2 years, and although I know many of these stops and have memorized these routes because I'm taking it so often, there still is so much that I don't understand. So many names are still so strange, you know, like you've never heard them before. And no matter how many times you read them, you're not gonna remember it. For any city that you travel, if it's a brand new city and you've never been here before, even if you've been there before and you have to get to places, everything looks so intimidating because you've never heard these names or these words before. You think you remember it and then you put your phone away and you don't remember anything. So I'm thinking, is there a way where you can leave it on your phone in a way that if you opened it, it always showed up? And Google Maps used to be this go-to place for me, you know. And a couple of months ago, they rolled out an update where you always had to keep your GPS on. I don't do that because I like to save battery. You have to keep your GPS always on. And if you turn it off and open Google Maps, it starts calculating again. And most of the times I'm inside the metro and I don't have network. I don't have GPS access either. And then it's just calculating and I've forgotten where I had to go, which metro I had to take, I've forgotten all of that stuff. Google Maps was awesome until they broke it with that feature. So that brings us back to the same question that we started with. If you're in a new place and you don't remember the name of the city and name of the place that you're going to, is there a way you can leave it on your phone that you can always come back to see it? Screenshot is one way, but is there another way where it's just there? So I have two quick tips that will help you out when you're traveling with your phone as your only guide. If you have a human guide, that's the best. Actually, I prefer the phone because it's so reliable and I can search for, you know, specific things that people may not know themselves. Talking to people is fun, but knowing everything is fun too. The first step that I can give you guys, get offline maps. This is what I do if I'm going to a new place and I don't know what's happening around there. I just get the offline maps. I hope that's not too noisy. Before we dive into how to do it with the phone, a quick word about how offline maps works is it saves a copy on your phone. It's somewhere between 50 and 150 megabytes. Google Maps is updating every day, you know. When people say that a business is closed or a new business is opened up over here, a new supermarket is opened up, to be timely relevant, what they do is they update their Google Maps. So in a year, what you downloaded last year won't be relevant anymore and you need to update it. When you open Google Maps, hit menu and go to offline maps, and here it shows you all the downloaded maps you have. You can also choose by yourself which offline maps you want to choose. Make sure the whole city is within this square and hit download. That's the first step. So now you have an offline copy. This won't take care of directions, but it will still let you search when you don't have internet access. So if you're going to a country or a city where you may not have internet access, then this is very helpful. Really important things like the train station, the bus station, so many supermarkets and all that stuff, you'll find it with your Google Maps. That's the first tip. Moving on swiftly to number two, make sure to save these places or star them. If you look at my Google Maps, you'll see there were already stars on my map. That's because these places are places that I go to pretty frequently. So if you know that you're gonna travel this place, maybe not every day, but often, once you found it, hit save and star this place. You can also leave a label as church or just make a new list over here. Another thing that I like to do with my Google Maps, this is not really a tip, maybe a tip 0.5, half a tip, if you will. Another thing that I like to do is put up my home and my work. If I'm in another place and someone's dropping me off and they're asking me directions to your home from here, you don't really know, just pull out Google Maps and type home. Even if you don't have the best internet right now, it will show you where home is, it'll show you the directions for right now, and life is fun. Those are the two quick tips. But before we finish, I'd like to say something about directions and navigations. So all that we have just been discussing about, that's been directions, right? Navigations is a whole new feature. It's this triangle pointing upward, which looks like you work for the Air Force or something, this awesome, cool logo. But what this does is it tracks you every second when you're moving to make sure that you're always in the center, and it narrates directions to you. Now this is really helpful if you're driving a car or driving a motorcycle. I discovered this feature back in 2012 when I was traveling by motorbike. Thanks, Dad, for that awesome motorbike when I was in Bangalore. And when I had to get to a certain place, I would put it up on Google Maps, hit navigation, and leave the phone in my pocket. You know, and then it keeps narrating to you where you're supposed to take turns and stuff. This was really excellent because it was like this all-knowing companion who guided you when you're traveling. So I had one earphones on and one earphones off to hear the cars honking around and ambient noise, and the earphone will tell me where I'm supposed to go, you know. It did this with a very heavy American accent. How it helped me was... I started remembering the names of the roads, you know, and I started remembering the names of these city areas in Bangalore thanks to this navigation feature. That's been it for this video, guys. I hope those 20 pence help you when you are traveling with Google Maps. Take care of yourselves. I'll see you next week, and until then, keep learning.